day. All the way, all the way. We going to hail your name. Show me a mountain God cannot move.
Ibara o, Ibara o,
Ibara, Ibara,
Ibara o, Ibara o.
Show me a story God cannot change.
Ibara o, Ibara o,
Ibara, Ibara o,
Ibara o, Ibara o.
Koloru ko la 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 la. Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Nissi,
Nani Gibuchi.
He sing and do a yellow bube,
Nani Gibuchi. Jehovah, Jehovah, I na see the mela.
Oh, yeah, remember, oh, yeah, remember,
Nani Gibuchi.
Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Nissi,
Nani Gibuchi.
He sing and do a yellow bube,
Nani Gibuchi. Jehovah, Jehovah, I na see the mela.
And you're a yanu, he's a yanu, you're a quarter of me.
Jehovah,
Jehovah,
I will testify until I see Jesus face to face. I was carrying that pregnancy. Before I carried pregnancy, I've done IVF, it failed. If you are here, like the reverend said, if you are here and you didn't collect, now you sabi. If I came from Lagos, crossed how many rivers, how many waiting, came and collected my own, you don't have no excuse. Because me here, I did IVF. If you see me doing IVF, I sat like this in my upstairs parlor. I didn't even reach my downstairs parlor. Make baby no come out. I just sit down like this. If they call me, I won't answer. They say, praise the Lord. I say, hallelujah. Make baby no come out. I spend millions. After all my stay for 2 weeks crossing my leg, I didn't dance. I stopped dancing. I'll be using my head to dance. Make baby no come out. It did not work. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Now he said, God came and arranged me. Use this daddy, this same daddy, to arrange me. I became Iyabeji. I became Mama Ijima. The pregnancy that I was trying to hold during IVF, I didn't work. I was pregnant. I did not know I was pregnant. I was dancing. And the one that could hold pregnancy. Held it!
Hey!
By the time doctor told me I'm pregnant, I said, hey, I've been dancing. And the baby's still there. Oh, 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 oh,
oh, oh,
oh, oh, oh,
oh, oh, oh, oh, oh,
oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh,
One thing good about our sister's songs is that there's a story behind every song. And as you dance, you are next in line for a miracle also. Amen. Give a clap to this beautiful choir, the Victory Voices.
You did it. Oh, made a way standing here. knowing how we'll get through this test. Yeah. But holding on to faith, you know best. Nothing can catch you by surprise. You got this figured out, and you're watching us now, yeah. And when it looked as if we can't win, yeah, you wrapped us in your arms and stepped in, and everything we need you supply. You got this in control, and now we know that you made a way. When our backs were against the wall, and it looked as if it was over, Lord, you made a way. And we're standing here only because you made a way. Hey, oh, Lord, you made a way, oh, for me. Now we're here, not knowing how we'll get through this test. Because of you and nothing we've done to deserve the love and mercy you show, but your grace was strong enough to keep us up, and you, oh, you made a way when our backs were
against the wall.
Only because you made a way. Yeah, yeah. You made a way. Yeah, yeah. Yes, you made a way. A
Can the happiest person shout hallelujah? Let me hear. I want you to find four persons of your choice and give a prophetic pronouncement and say to each one, this night, you are among those that God has remembered. You may be seated. God bless you. We dragged our daughter back to Rio for this program to remind her that she's one of the daughters of this altar. By that, I mean nobody is allowed to molest her, or we shall go on 200 night fast for God to punish the person. When you stand up and greet the bread, give her the microphone. Remember, you've heard me say over and again, my dream is to produce proof producers.
Thank you, Chief.
And until you become one, I will not stop. I don't need to ask people to pay for the buses. Even though this night I'll ask you for offering to help us repair. I bought 8 buses at the cost of 2 million naira per bus. I wanted to renew all the buses, to replace them. I was shocked to hear my suppliers say the price had gone from 2 million to 29 million. But I can't imagine these buses disappearing from Uyo Street. So we're going to replace any broken parts. We're going to repaint all the buses because the buses speak of the goodness of the Lord. And the buses speak of God's preparedness and readiness to bless his people. We are a family. In a family, everybody gives according to the blessings of God upon his life. But everybody cannot have the same amount of income. Every one of us has a gift. You are called by God to invest in the lives of others. When the choir sings every Wednesday, you notice that some of them are just greatly gifted. And by listening to them, your own increase will begin to rise up. When you hear our daughter Dennis sing, she sings like a person that has endless energy. I was shocked when I tried to appreciate her before her husband. The man shocked me when he said she can sing up to 1,000 songs or 2,000 songs. It's not ordinary. But we are called by God to contribute that gift God gave us for others. Don't hide it. Don't keep it. And you will be among those that God will remember every day. Let's have our guests greet us. Let's have the Archbishop, Udeme Salmon. Can you greet us? Even though you didn't come with your wife and is now a demand, next time come with her. If she's not willing to come bribe her.
It's noted, sir.
Good.
Hallelujah. We have come again to receive what would take us throughout 365 days.
Amen.
It's in the house.
Amen. Let's have the principal of Assemblies of God Bible College, a brother and a friend, among the leaders of the Assemblies of God. In response to our request yesterday, he's here with his wife. Can the two greet us? Somebody give the microphone to greet us.
Yes, yes, yes. Thank you, sir. It's a privilege again to be here. I promise I will bring my wife. I have fulfilled that promise.
Please give him a better clap offering, somebody.
May God increase the music makers and producers of this great organization. What? Unto God be the glory in this place for now and evermore. Unto God, unto Jesus, be thy glory in this house for now and evermore. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Unto God be the glory in this church.
I don't know if you know how difficult it is to form a duet with your husband or your wife. This is, those who have water in them know the call of the sea. The woman who just sang now had written a book on music. Give her a good clap off from somebody. Let's have Jerry greet us, even though he has spoken to us before, but let's have him greet us.
Praise the Lord.
He is among our dependable, reliable sons. A son we are proud of. I know there is a little bit contention over it. Some people are not happy that we prefer them above others. It's not our making, it's God's making. Promotion comes from God and God only. Apostle Blessing. Who is Apostle Blessing? Where is she? Okay. You have changed your name. Blessing Banigo. I've not heard that blessing before. Oh, is that the wife's name? How can we have a son and not know the real name? All the same, give him the microphone to greet the brethren.
Happy New Year, everyone. Job said in Job 10, verse 12, for God has granted us life and favor, and his visitation has preserved our spirit. It is a privilege to have a father that is very caring, that will find out everything about you. I want to say that it is joy for us to be here. expect a miracle in this program. Hallelujah.
Those who cannot celebrate others may never be celebrated. We have 32 people tonight that God shall revoke and annul the cross under which they labor. At the appropriate time, I will release the power of God that breaks every yoke. And if you are one of those 32 persons, you go home with great laughter. Let's see the book of John, chapter 9. We'll take verse 1 and we'll take verse 2. I have used that Bible passage to counsel so many people. But tonight I intend to correct myself by giving you additional information about that Bible line. What does it say? John chapter 9, verse 1.
And as Jesus passed by, he saw a man which was blind from his birth.
He saw a man who was born blind.
And his disciple asked him.
The disciples asked him,
saying,
Master,
who did sin?
This man,
or his parents, that he was born blind.
Jesus answered.
Neither this man nor his parents, but that the works of God should be made manifest in him.
There is what I call generational curse, which some of you know. Let's go to the book of Leviticus, chapter 26. We take verse 40 and verse 42. There is a generational curse, something that repeats in your family. A tragedy that repeats. Something that reoccurs from generation to generation. What does it say? Yes, sir.
If they shall confess their iniquity.
Now, the Bible says, if you will confess your iniquity.
And the iniquity of their fathers.
And iniquity of your fathers.
With their trespass.
Yes.
Which they trespassed against me.
Yes.
And that also they have walked contrary unto me.
Yes.
And that I also have walked contrary unto them.
Yes.
And have brought them into the land of their enemies.
Yes.
If then their uncircumcised hearts be humbled.
If then their uncircumcised hearts could be humbled.
And then accept of the punishment of their iniquity.
And would be willing to pay any price for the iniquities.
Then I will remember my covenant with them. And also my covenant with Isaac.
Yes.
And also my covenant with Abraham. I remember. And I will remember the land.
There is what we call generational curses. A curse as a result of your background, of your parentage. But I want to counter it. Let's see the book of John's Gospel, chapter 9, we take verse 1. We'll go to the book of Luke, chapter 10, we take verse 19. Yes, sir.
And as Jesus passed by, he saw a man which was...
No. What did I say? Let's see the book of Luke, chapter 9, verse 1. And then chapter 10, verse 19 of the same Luke. Yes, sir.
Then he called his 12 disciples together and gave them power and authority. Over all devils.
Over all demons.
And to cure diseases. And he sent them to preach the kingdom of God.
Yes.
And to heal the sick.
Yes. Run now to chapter 10, verse 19 of the book of Luke.
Behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents
and scorpions
and over all the powers of the enemy,
including the spirit that enforces curses upon the lives of men. A curse is upon a pronouncement of punishment against you by somebody superior to you. It could be a native doctor, it could be your father, it could be your mother, it could be an enemy. When that, every curse starts with spoken word. Every curse starts with spoken word. When that spirit is at work, when you give your life to Christ, you have the power to cancel even your family foundational curse. But we belong to two categories of followers. There are people who belong to the class of Jacob. Let's see the book of Genesis chapter 27, verse 27 through verse 29. There are people that have favor despite their mistakes and sins. Yes, sir.
And he came near.
And Jacob came near
and kissed
to his father. And the father kissed him.
And he smelled the smell of his raiment.
He smelled the smell of his son.
And blessed him.
And blessed Jacob. And wrongly. Said, he blessed him wrongly.
And said.
And said.
See.
See.
The smell of my son
is the smell of my son.
It's a smell of the field.
Yes, it's a smell of a field that the Lord has blessed.
Therefore, God give thee of the dew.
God give thee of the dews of heaven,
and the fatness of the earth,
and the fatness of the earth,
and plenty of corn and wine,
and plenty of corn and wine.
Let people serve thee.
Let people serve you.
And nations bow down.
Let nations bow before you.
Be Lord over thy brethren.
Be Lord over thy own brethren.
And let thy mother's sons bow down to thee.
Let your mother's children bow before you.
Cursed be everyone that
curses
thee.
Cursed be anyone that curses you.
And blessed be he that blesses
thee. Blessed be he that blesses you. You remember that Jacob had just practiced Nigerian 419. And when the father was mistakenly pronouncing blessings over him, being a blind man, God kept quiet. God could have spoken. God could have corrected Isaac to say, "This is not Esau." He had the mind to bless Esau. I don't want to go into the details of the card that was played that threw up Jacob. But do you know, as I speak now, when the father discovered the mistake he made, do you know, he did not revoke what he had spoken. He did not cancel it. He allowed it. It's a puzzle. One of the things we may never know in this life. Therefore, if you come from a family where poverty rules from generation to generation, and despite all your fasting and your prayer, you're still struggling with limitation and lack and struggling in your life as a child of God, you have to join the same Jacob in chapter 32 of the book of Genesis. Let's say verse 24 through verse 28.
And Jacob was left alone.
In the battles of life, we all fight alone, all of us. In fact, life is so funny. Do you know you can be sick without your wife feeling the pain you are going through, even when she's beside you? You can be, I don't know whether you have ever been to a labor room and watch a woman go through labor pain. One of us called me and said, "Pray for me. I've been in labor for 2 days now and I'm getting tired." I was frightened because the word, that expression simply means she was about to surrender, to give up, to quit. The next thing would be death. Life is a puzzle. You can be in pain without your partner, your spouse, knowing the pain you are going through. The Bible says Jacob was alone. And what happened, sir?
And there wrestled.
There's what we call wrestling prayer. When you ask God for a miracle and there is no miracle, when you fast and pray and there is no miracle, when you cry, because weeping prayer is a powerful form of prayer. Let's go to the book of Mark chapter 10 and let's take verse 46 and 47. Weeping prayer is a powerful form of prayer. It can compel the maker of heaven and earth to stand still. Yes, sir. What happened, sir?
And they went to Jericho. And as he went out of
Jericho
with the disciples,
yes,
the great number of people,
blind Bartimaeus,
the son of Timaeus,
yes,
sat by the highway.
When he heard that Jesus was passing by,
he began to cry out and say,
"Yes,
Jesus,
thou son of David." I don't know whether that word David produces a feeling in your heart. Our God keeps covenants. When he makes a promise, he'll abide by it. In fact, I would almost say he allows his promises to govern him. Read on, sir.
"Thou son of David, have mercy on me."
Have mercy on me.
"And many charged him that he should hold his peace."
Many asked him to shut up his mouth.
But he cried the more louder. Thou son of David,
have mercy on me.
And Jesus stood still.
Now, this was a hopelessly, wretchedly, suddenly poor man. He was blind and poor. I had a friend who has passed on to eternity. He was blind, but he was a professor. He was blind, but he was rich. When Sister Comfort, a medical doctor, married him, she said to me, "Omar, I married him out of pity." And I said, "Yes and no. If he had been a poor man, he wouldn't have pitied him." I don't know if you know what poverty can do to a man. Only poverty has no father. We're fighting over who are Denny's fathers and the Lord. And they said, she didn't mention my name in her interview, and I said she forgot because she's my daughter. And I have a stake and can fight over her. The only person who is forgotten, who has no father, is a poor man. Every successful man has more than one parent. Is that correct? In fact, if you are poor, your own relations will even reject you. They will reject you. But the day this God promotes you, those who didn't remember your name will remember your name. A poor man, hopelessly poor, wretchedly poor, and was also a handicapped person. He knew the power of weeping prayer. But what is the meaning of weeping prayer? Weeping prayer is you saying to God, "Father, I can't put my prayer in words. Let my tears speak for me." Wow, that's powerful. Any husband here whose wife's tears cannot move him to give help to his wife is not fit to be a husband. She didn't marry a human being. She married goats or rats. Because tears were given to God, were given to women by God to make a hard man to become tender and be loving and be caring and care for his wife. But a man who can feel no emotion at the sound of the tears of his, at the sound of the weeping of his wife, that man is not fit to be a human being. shouldn't have married. Tears can melt any hearts. And amazingly, can melt the heart of God. When you have prayed and cried, when you have asked for a miracle, when you have fasted for a miracle, and nothing happens, then you will do what we call wrestling with God. Wrestling with God simply says, Father, let's go back to Jacob. Let's go to verse 25.
And when he saw that he prevailed not against him, he touched the hollow of his thigh. And the hollow of Jacob's thigh was out of joint as he wrestled with him. And he said, let me go, for the day breaketh. And he said, I will not let thee go.
I will not let you go.
Except thou bless me.
Except thou bless me. For 15 years, 1 month in every 3 months, I've said to God, if you cannot give me anointing sufficient enough to turn lamentation into laughter, let me die. I pity my wife for going through that kind of pain with me. She would say to me, what do you want? You have filled the National Stadium. What else do you want? You have filled a bus stadium or where the stadium. What else? Madam, wait. There is something more this God can do. I want you to come to that place this night where you say to God, there is something more you can do for me. Everyone here, your life must be a blessing to somebody. In fact, when people were dancing, there's a daughter of mine who danced from this area. I won't tell you her name. I've not seen her dance before. I was looking at her father. So somebody can move this woman to dance. You have a gift, or God can give you a gift that will be a blessing to others. Go for it. Demand it. Ask for it. I hate people who are selfish. And surprisingly, madam, hold that child, give the child breast or bread. Please. I want you to hear me. The most cheated man under the sun is the selfish man, you know. A selfish man was in trouble. God will not come. Can we see the book of Psalm chapter 20? Let's take verse 1 to 3. The most cheated man under the sun is a selfish man. Yes, sir.
The Lord hear thee in the day of trouble.
The Bible said God will hear you in the days of your trouble.
The name of the God of Jacob defend thee.
The name of this God of Jacob shall fight for you and defend you.
Send thee help from the sanctuary.
He will send help from the sanctuary.
And strengthen thee out of Zion.
He will strengthen you out of Zion.
Remember all thy offerings.
But it will be because he remembered your offering.
And accept thy burnt sacrifices.
Yes. There are people who all they ask is, what can I take out of life? What can I gain? Can you imagine somebody coming here only to find how to steal our money? This is money that belongs to God. I said to my children, don't pick anything in this fellowship that is not mine. Don't touch the fellowship money or property or vehicle, because there will be a cross that will follow you. There are people who come and all they ask, what can I gain? But there are others who fast and pray that they may be a blessing to somebody. And those who have that desire, those who have this propensity, this tendency, those who have this hunger in their heart to be a blessing to others, you know, the sky shall be the starting point, not the limit. Life is funny. Life is funny. Can we see the book of Matthew chapter 10? Let's take verse 40 and 41. Oh, Jesus.
He that receiveth you, receiveth me.
He that receiveth the sent prophet hath received God who sent him.
He that received me received him that sent me.
Yes.
He that received a prophet in the name of a prophet shall receive a prophet's reward.
Yes.
And he that received a righteous man in the name of a righteous man shall receive a righteous man's reward.
Yes.
And whosoever shall give to drink unto one of
whosoever shall give a cup of water
unto these little ones,
unto any member of the fellowship,
only in the name of the disciple,
yes,
verily I say unto you, he shall in no wise lose his reward.
He will not lose his reward. But there are those who keep asking, what can I steal? Remember, one of our rectors stole our money. And I said to him, I can't take you to court. I don't have time to go to any court and start arguing with your lawyer. Just go home. If you bring back the money, if you bring back part of the money, but if you refuse to bring back part of the money, you'll be in God's prison house. I saw him 3 months after. I thought he was a madman. He said, everything said about me is already happening. What part of the money did you bring back? I expected him to bring 5 naira, 10 naira, 1,000. No, he told me I didn't bring any money, but tell God to forgive me. God will forgive you if you can bring just one, some part of the money you took. We're going back to chapter 32 of the book of Genesis. Remember that Jacob had been blessed by the father, but there were little foxes in his life that were eating up the vine. Before you go to that, let's go to the book of Song of Solomon. Let's take verse 2, we'll take verse 15. What an awesome God will serve. This program we're having is to make sure everything in your life is in place for the plane to take off. Will it take off? You didn't hear me. I said we are running this 4 days program to make sure everything in your aircraft is in place. For God wants your aircraft to take off. It shall take off. It shall take off. It shall take off. It shall take off. Raise your hand and shout hallelujah, somebody. Read on, sir.
Take us the foxes.
Do what?
Take us the foxes. The little foxes that spoil the vines.
The Bible said, take care of the little foxes that eat up the vine. Find out if there is anything in your life that makes God unhappy. There are too many things that can make your life miserable, that can make God abandon you, that can stop the power of God from functioning in your life, that can stop you from claiming God's promises for you. Too many things. But I'm here to show you what you can do to overcome all of them and come to the place God wants you to be. It is painful to see a believer struggle through life. It is wrong. It does not add up. Whatever has made this so must be changed these remaining 2 days. We are back to Jacob, chapter 32. Let's take verse 26 and 20. Let's take 27.
And he said unto him, what is thy name? And he said, Jacob.
No, let's go back where Jacob. That 26 where Jacob said to him, I won't let you go.
And he said,
unless you bless me.
For the day breaketh. And he said, I will not let thee go, except thou bless me.
There is nothing as powerful as that hunger and determination. Yes, you are not doing well, but you have to do something to move God to change his attitude towards you and change his position towards you. Our walk with God is like our walk with banks. When I left school in America, I left money in my account. 3 years after, I went back to U.S. I went to the bank to demand that that account be activated and the money given to me. They said, sorry. For all the years you were not around, we didn't see you. We declared your account, what? Dormant. I don't know if you have heard that language before from bankers. It cuts your heart into two. It will force your heart to fall into your stomach. Cold blood will rush to your face. You begin to perspire like a native doctor on a Christmas morning. They said to me, sorry, we use the money in that account to service the account. So there's no money left. I didn't know when I shouted and said to them, you bankers in America, you are worse thieves than Nigerian bankers. Daniel Gotere was with me, my friend. He held me and said, oh man, stop, stop, stop. I'll give you that money from my own account. Don't shout at them. Don't fight them. They have too many powerful weapons to use against you. Hey, old boy, when will you give me the money? Tonight and tomorrow night, I want you to be in a fight, to be in a fighting mood and say to God, I will not give up. I will not surrender. I will not let you go unless you bless me. Because this God has more than 4 million type of blessings he can give you. Too many of them. My wife used to wonder, why are you so ambitious? You moved from Uyo with a crowd, with a choir of 5,000 members. You went with 23,000 prayer volunteers. You were able to hire 84 Molue buses. You brought Lagos to a halt for 1 week. What else do you want? Madam, you don't know how rich this God is. He can help me turn lamentation into laughter. He can help me turn the barren woman into a fruitful woman. He can help me turn a hopelessly wretched, stupidly poor man into one of the richest in Nigeria. He can help me call the dead back to life. He can anoint me to make the sick become healed. So don't ask me to stop. Ask him to do something for me. And the poor woman will say to me, I don't want to be a widow. Eat. Damn. There's time for everything. This one, this food, leave it. I don't know why she worries so much about me. Even this afternoon, she was asking me, when will you eat? Madam, we're not talking about eating. We're talking about setting captives free. Are you still here? Ministry is the light of a candle. Every candle spends itself to give light to others. And we are here that God may bring light to your life. Jesus said, this man was born blind, not because of wrong foundation. But a preacher can also say it was wrong foundation. The two will be correct. But I prefer what I've said now to you, that he has given you power above all the powers of the enemy. And that includes the power of the demon that enforces curses in every family. Your own shall be broken tonight. Be broken tonight. Be broken tonight. Be broken tonight.